Hi, this is Tom with the University of Iowa. I hear you're having a hard time figuring out which subspecialty in ophthalmology to go into. And so I'm going to make it very easy for you by just asking yourself, what sort of pet do I want the most? And that'll help your decision. Let's say, for example, that what you want is a cat, because you really don't care if that cat likes you or not. You just think cats are cool. You don't really care if that cat loves you or not. You just think it's interesting to watch how the cat moves through the house, or watch how the cat can jump so high. If that's the case, you should go into retina, because cat people love retina. They don't need feedback about how good things are. They just love the interesting animal, the cat. Let's say you like something like tarantulas. You like the way tarantulas have all these different habitats and how tarantulas could potentially be deadly. Well, if that's the case, you should go into neuro-ophthalmology, because they have crazy deadly diseases. They're interesting and difficult. Let's say, for example, you like little baby hedgehogs. Well, little baby hedgehogs are prickly, but they're so cute because they're so little. If that's what you like, I think I would go into pediatric ophthalmology. But if you're like me, and you love these little dogs like I do, you love the way they come home and they're so excited to see you, you love the way the little dogs are barking and accepting of all your imperfections, and they're just so happy to see you, then you should go into comprehensive ophthalmology, because our patients really, really appreciate what we do. They're so excited to see us. We get so much feedback that's positive, and that's one of the great things about being a comprehensive ophthalmologist. Now, what is a comprehensive ophthalmologist? It's somebody that mainly does cataract surgery and then does a lot of the other stuff in ophthalmology, like handling patients with more simple glaucoma, handling patients with more simple problems related to the other subspecialties in ophthalmology. And one of the great things about comprehensive ophthalmology is you can kind of pick and choose what's interesting to you. But the bread and butter for a comprehensive ophthalmologist is to do cataract surgery, maybe a few other surgeries one day a week, have clinic usually 3 or 3.5 days a week. And during those clinic days, you'll see a variety of patients. You'll see a lot of patients that return every year, and it's fun to see them, catch up on them and their lives. You'll see patients with acute problems that are nervous and scared. You can help them through that that process. You'll follow patients with chronic conditions like glaucoma over the course of their lifetime, and that's fun and satisfying to see how they're doing. There's a lot of really cool technology. If you're interested in physics and technology, there's so many interesting things going on in our field right now, both in the diagnostic area and also in the area of optics for the intraocular lenses that we place in our patients, which makes them even more excited when they come to see us, which makes them even more attractive to people like me that love dogs. So think about, what is your pet? What is the pet that you would most want to have? And that'll help you as you figure out what subspecialty you want to go into. This is Tom Woody, University of Iowa. Thank you very much.